Peace, y'all. Johnny Fastlane here. So, Meek Mill gets pulled over in Jamaica, and what's going on with 6ix9ine? Let's talk hip-hop.
You trying to take a picture of mine? I'm fucked up. Y'all pulled us over, and y'all said y'all want a picture of mine? Y'all scared us. We scared of police. Y'all gonna pull us over and say, yo, we thought we get locked up. Y'all said y'all want a picture?
Not like that.
They're gonna give us a police escort out of Kingston?
Where are you going?
Just give us a police escort out of Kingston. Y'all pulled us over. We thought we was getting in trouble.
Yo, so Meek Mill. So the police pull Meek Mill over, right, in Jamaica. And they scared, you know, they thinking, oh man, you know, Chris Brown just got detained in Paris 2 weeks ago. And now you got this. He like, oh man, I'm about to be locked up in a foreign country. It's a wrap. They're going to have to call this one and that one. Let me get Hov on the phone real quick. And the police wanted a picture with Meek Mill. It's so funny. They was like, yeah, we know, we just want a picture. No, nothing like that. Nothing like that. He's like, you want to give us a police escort out of Kingston? Because by then, you know, he probably was like, listen, I don't need no more of this. Like, just scares. He's like, yo, you going to give us a police escort out of Kingston? They're like, yeah, man, you know, sure. No problem, right? So Jamaica is dope, right? I go to Jamaica every single year. I got family in Jamaica. I got family in Kingston. You know, Jamaica is just like a whole different world, right? So Meek Mill is thinking like an American with his American brain, right? So here in America, you got cops, they pull you over. If you black, they might want to bother you. They might want to mess with you. In Jamaica, everybody's black. So it's none of that. So that racial barrier that we have to deal with, like all that stupidity here in America, they don't deal with that in Jamaica. Every single cop is black. So they ain't pulling you over for that, right? The president is black over there. All the presidents have been black in Jamaica, as far as I know. You know, there are a few white people in Jamaica that are Jamaican, but they're like of German descent. So they're called Jamaicans. And even those Jamaicans, they talk like, what the bumbaclot? You know, like they just be talking. They think they, I mean, well, they are Jamaican, you know. So Meek Mill and his whole crew, they like, yo, we were scared. We was thought we was about to get arrested. We thought we was about to go to jail. Yo, Jamaica, they cool. Like, if you a star, they call you a DJ. So Meek Mill's a rapper, but in Jamaica, they call it DJ. Same thing, right? So if you're a DJ, you know, if you got tats, you know, they love that kind of stuff in Jamaica. They love American culture, and they don't really bother you. Like, when I go to Jamaica, everybody's chill, they cool. They be like, yo, what up? You know, they love the tats and everything. It's just funny, man, because for like 2 seconds, Meek was like, oh, man, here we go. But nah, Jamaica is cool, man. I really ain't seen nothing crazy ever go down in Jamaica. If you American, they just want to give you weed and they want you to sign this for them. And they trying to sell you everything. They'll sell you a wooden carving. They'll sell you some drugs. They'll sell you whatever you need in Jamaica. They got it for you. They're like, here. We got this for you. Here. You know, they ain't about like really harassing people like that. The police don't do that. I've seen the police pull over drunk drivers in Jamaica and let them go. Be like, all right, yo, just please be careful. If you a mile away from your house, just go, you know? I mean, it's cool, man. It was just a funny situation, you know. Meek Mill is there chilling with popcorn. Maybe they about to do a video or something like that. It looked like they was filming a video for something. So Meek probably got a joint coming out with him. You know, Meek been all over the world, man. From this prison reform thing, chilling with Hov, to, you know, in Jamaica, to just like doing big things, man. And I like to see it, yo. I really like to see it. He be in Brooklyn chilling with Fabolous. It's like, this is a whole new Meek right here. And it's dope. So the news came out, man, that 6ix9ine, so the other day, like the day before yesterday, right, it's Friday, Wednesday, you know, I was doing it, I did a video, we talked about 6ix9ine, we said basically that we don't know, you know, what's going on. People are coming out saying that he told the feds that it was Kuda B who shot at Chief Keef in Times Square, but we don't know. Right. It turns out that, yeah, man, 6ix9ine on Saturday pled guilty to, I guess, some lesser counts, because he was facing like 32 years at first, right? So he pled guilty to 9 counts of drug trafficking, having firearms. Remember, they found that one gun in his crib, the same gun that was used in that one robbery, right? So he pled guilty to that. He pled guilty to drug trafficking. He pled guilty to gang activity and some other charges too. 9 different charges, right? So then I guess once he pled guilty to that, they, you know, we don't know, right? Because the paperwork still hasn't come out. But he basically said, okay, I'll take a deal. And then they started asking him about other stuff. So not only that, but, you know, and this is coming from every area and every direction, where some people are saying that there was 4 guys involved in that shooting, but Kuda B was the one that pulled the trigger, but Shotty was there too. They were just saying, like, you know, 6ix9ine is going to remain in jail. So that February 20th date that he was supposed to go back to court, which is in 20 days, is not happening now. And that instead, he's going to go back. He's going to stay in jail, federal jail. And then he's going to go back to court on the January 2020. So a year from now, and then he'll get sentenced. Obviously, he'll get credit for time served if he's already been in there for like a year and a half. It's just crazy because there's so many different accounts of what 6ix9ine is saying, or what 6ix9ine is doing, or who he's telling on. But there's just one thing for sure, though. And that one thing for sure, though, is that it seems like and it's hard. Like, who wants to believe that 6ix9ine is telling? But it's one thing for sure that it seems like he really is telling. Like, they must have told him, like, bro, you ain't getting out. You know, and it's either you tell on everybody and you take the 10 years, or you don't tell on anybody and get 30. You know, he said that he was the one that sent Kuda B to shoot at Chief Keef, but he was only doing that to try to scare Chief Keef. He wasn't really trying to kill him. If he pleads guilty to all this, then maybe they don't get him on attempted murder, right? If he's the boss. But here's the thing, like, if I'm the boss, right, who do I tell on? I tell on my, you know, the dudes that was working for me, like, yo, no, you know, yeah, I paid him to go do that. You know, I paid him to go do this. I don't know, man. I think that 6ix9ine just got in over his head. You know what I'm saying? Like, you was acting like you was down and it was all gang, and then you wanted to, like, maintain a certain image, and you trying to maintain that image messed you up, because you went all in. You went full retard. You know what I'm saying? Yo, I don't know. You did it to rise up the ranks of Nontray. You did it to maintain the ranks of Nontray. Let me tell you something, yo. If you got money, you don't really have to do none of that. But I guess he wanted to still, you know, have them feel like, yo, I'm here, I'm down. You know, I'm with y'all. Up until the end. But, you know, also, they shouldn't have been doing all that with him. They shouldn't have been doing all that for him. They know that, I mean, they didn't grow up with 6ix9ine, right? They all was from, you know, the same hood. You know, everybody's from Bushwick and Bed-Stuy and Brooklyn, but they didn't grow up with him. They don't know what he's cut from, the cloth. You know what I'm saying? They don't know his character. You know what I'm saying? So why would you, just because dude got money, why would you include him in your crimes and everything? Like, that was foolish. Like, they could have went on years and years and years, just like they was doing for years and years and years, doing whatever they was doing, you know, Nontray, you know what I'm saying, Trey White, and didn't have to deal with that. But 6ix9ine is what really made it hot, you know what I'm saying? Then, you know, him with the rainbow hair, and him with the cameras and the flashy and the rapping and everything like that. And yeah, you bringing them peoples right to our doorstep, and that's what happened, man. He sold his soul to the devil, you know. And when you sell your soul to the devil, yo, nothing is gonna turn out Right. And I don't mean like he sold his soul to the devil as in like, you know, religious kind of thing. But whenever you do something that's like really against your norm or really against your morals to try to gain something, and you think that you could take a shortcut there instead of like working hard and doing that, then you mess up, man. And the crazy thing is like, yo, you could troll these rappers. Tell YG suck your dick. Tell Trippie Red to suck your dick. Lay up in the bed with Trippie Red's ex-girlfriend. Do all that. Because that's cool, man. But when you... That's entertainment. You know what I'm saying? So, are you not entertained? You know, entertain us. For real. But when you go and you, like, really are in the hood now, you know, committing crimes and getting certain people robbed. And, I mean, this is, like, so many stories coming out about, like, what he was involved in that it's just crazy. And I don't want to sit here and be like, he did A, B, C, D, you know. But he did a lot. And it seems like he admitted to doing it, you know. And this is not, you know, the Shade Room that's reporting it. And not even TMZ, because sometimes TMZ be on some fugazi type stuff. But this is the New York Times, bro. Like, this is CBS. Like, this is NBC, bro. Like they don't just report stuff. They check their sources and they try to, you know, make sure that it's actual factual before they put it out, you know. And it seems like, I mean, I haven't seen no paperwork at all whatsoever yet, but it seems like it is actual factual, you know. He admitted to all this on Saturday, and the documents were sealed up until today. So the prosecutors put out a petition to the judge to get the documents open because they wanted the public to hear it for whatever reason. And today, Friday, they opened up the documents, and now everybody knows what happened and what was going on. But this happened on Saturday, so 6ix9ine already knew about this before. I'm sure Shotty already knew about this before, and everybody else, Crippy, Harv, Kuda. But I don't think that they caught Kuda yet. So we'll see what's going on, but it ain't looking good for 6ix9ine. And, you know, we was all like free 6ix9ine and everything. I hope he gets out, but it don't look like 6ix9ine is coming out no time soon, man. And as soon as 6ix9ine gets sentenced, Bobby Shmurda is coming home, which is cool, you know. And then Bobby Shmurda is like a whole different side to the coin. So both from Brooklyn, both do that gangster rap, both was really in the streets. Well, 6ix9ine wasn't really in the streets until a year ago. Like, everything that's on 6ix9ine's rap sheet is like from 2017, 2018. Like, he was not a gang member and all that, you know, but he got in over his head. If you know Mel Murder, and he's like, yo, man, yeah, I know Cameron, I know Jim Jones down with Dipset, whatever. If you know Shoddy and they're like, yo, we could put you here because we have connections in the industry and we know that you're trying to get famous. 6ix9ine was trying to get famous. He was trying to blow up. He was trying to get money. He was trying to get put on by any means necessary. And he would have did anything to his detriment to be big, to be famous, to be a millionaire, to be that nigga. And you know what? He kept on doing it. Once he made it, I don't know if he thought that someone would snatch it from him, but he kept on doing it. And he kept on doing it, and he got himself right in prison, yo. And it's crazy. On the other hand, Bobby Shmurda grew up with these dudes, right? They from the block. They knew him. They knew him since he was Chewy. They knew him since a little kid. Bobby Shmurda was involved in a little bit of this, a little bit of that. And he got locked up with his whole crew. He didn't have to fund people. He didn't have to pay anybody. He didn't meet them a year ago. Those were like his real partners. To the point where Shmurda was going to get 5 years. Roddy Rebel was going to get 12. And Bobby Shmurda said, I'll take 7 if you give my boy 7 too. And we both get out at the same time. Cool. You know what I'm saying? That's a stand-up dude. That's a dude that didn't tell no extra stuff about what was going on. That's a dude that said, you know what? We sit down for a little bit. When we come home, we're going to get welcomed back into hip-hop with open arms. Meek Mill is the first time I ever heard of Bobby Shmurda. Brought him out on stage. They were supposed to come out with a mixtape with the Migos, Shmigo Gang. That's probably going to happen. Maybe not. You know what I'm saying? But The next year, this time, Bobby Shmurda will be out. And it's kind of like we traded 6ix9ine for Bobby Shmurda, man. Which is crazy, yo. And I would have hoped that 6ix9ine would have been talking and all this and that. But if he wasn't talking, dude would have been locked up for the next 30 years. He would have been in there until he was like 50 years old. Which is crazy. And he probably couldn't see it. And he was like, nah, I'm not going to let him do that to me. And he knows that they was going to find him guilty. So he decides to start talking. So let's see what's going to happen now, man. I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But this seems to be official tissue right here. And, you know, we'll see. But let me know what y'all think. Oh, yo, we got to end this on a good note. Check out this funny ass picture with Lil Yachty and Ludacris from like back in the day. Yo, let me know what y'all think about everything. You know, Meek Mill is a whole fool, and 6ix9ine really did that, yo. I think. Like, comment, share, subscribe, and y'all know what to do. Peace.